I think the first thing we thought about was that, first of all, it looked really nice coming in here. It just looked like this tiny little tropical island.
I've seen corals, Nemo fishes, I see jellyfish.
My mother wanted to have a fish sanctuary before, but the people don't like. Mahirap kasi mas marami ang against kasi pangisdaan nila yon.
Mayroong mga tagasilima nagpunta dito. Pagkatapos sabi nila, mag-seminar mo na. E, kaunti na kami. Mga 20% ang mag-attend sa seminar. Yung iba ayaw.
It's not so easy to set up a sanctuary in the short term that it requires sort of long-term participation and active sort of involvement of the community to make it fully successful over the years. It needs to be done in partnership with their local government unit, in this case the municipality of Dawan, and also to work well with outside facilitating NGOs or academic institutions. In the case of Apple, Silliman has played a major role in making it successful over the years. But starting about 1982, there was a bit of controversy about the enforcement of the sanctuary, and there was some reluctance on the part of the community to really be vigilant. But then by 1984, the Silliman had received a grant from USAID through the Asia Foundation to start a community-based project that helped sort of facilitate working with the community on acceptance of the sanctuary.
Tapos parang mawala yung takot nila, sinabihan ko sila na kung pwede lang yung pipiliin na fish sanctuary doon sa lugar na hindi pa isdaan. At saka mayroon kaming 2 years contract. Yung 2 years, tuturuan nila kami paano pag-establish ng sanctuary. Tapos pag after 2 years, kung successful or not successful, kailangan nilang umalis.
Pero pag lampas ng 2 taon, pag mo-ipik ang atong project, patuloy. Patuloy natin.
I was the Kabataang Barangay Chairman during those days. So I was involved in gathering youth. We used to have a small hut there along the beach. Actually, it's a hut where our community organizers stay. And then it is also a hut where we're going to meet the people. And then we sleep overnight there in that small hut.
Gumawa kami ng 7 groups dahil kailangan mayroong magbabantay.
It's really hard. All activities there. I mean, fishing, including collecting of any marine organism inside the marine sanctuary, is completely prohibited.
Isang grupo, mayroon na konsyan, isang leader. Sila ang mag-guardia ng isang linggo, 1 week. Tapos kasama rin yung mga asawa, then doon na sila matutulog. Tapos kami mag-contribute ng isang lata na bigas. Tapos yung mga babae, sila ang sila magluluto.
They ask their women, their wife, to attend the meetings. If you look at the General Assembly here, majority is the women and only few men.
Isang taon kalati siguro yon. Ang daming isda yan. Makita namin sa yung mga agin sa amin dito. Yun. Kita mo yon, may sanctuary, maraming isda. Siguro na, kita mo, mayo na. Oh, voluntary kami. Lahat dito sa Apo ay magbantay na kami dito pag illegal fishing. Kahit na taga-ator at taga-atin dito, pag mayroong pusunos na yung tubli, walang dynamite na, wala na. At saka yung aming muruami, wala.
Nakita nilang difference dahil pag magpukot sila mangisda, mayroon nang makuha. Pag mag-hook and eye sila mangisda, mayroon nang nakuha.
Pag South Monsoon, pagpunta mo doon sa fishing ground ng isang sakayan, makahuli ng mga 30 kilos, 40 kilos. Isang mamsa lang yan. Pero noon wala.
The whole island is dive sites all around. The main dive site here is this one here in front, the Chapel Point, the Mamsa Point, and the Marine Sanctuary. But the best diving spot here is in the north, which is Coconut.
It's nice when you're diving, the visibility is great. There's a lot of corals compared to the one at the chapel out here.
So maganda talaga ang future kung i-maintain. At mayroon akong feeling na pag hindi ma-strong ang protection sa community, masisira ang island dahil sa maraming divers.
Diving average per month, I think not less than 1,000 per month. You can have 60 or 70 or 100 divers here in one day. During high season or peak season, we can have 20 diving boats here, loaded with at least 6, and some is 18 divers in one boat.
Apo Island has started that user fee in 1990s. I was an ISB member at the time, so I was tasked to sponsor an ordinance imposing user fee in Apo Island, including the organization to manage the area. What we were earned at that time was only used for the purchase of the marker buoys, the sinker, the equipment and materials that needed in preserving the area, the construction of the patrol boat, and the support for the maintenance of this Bantay Dagat. That's very minimal. It's not enough. So I find it's really a need for the local government to support by appropriating funds for that.
Yeah, when the law, the NIPAS law was passed, it was declared 1994, August 9, as a protected landscape and seascape. The entrance fee before was 25 pesos per head. We changed that now to 100 pesos. And the diving fee inside the marine reserve before was 150 pesos. Now it's 300 pesos. So we have an average collection per month this year or last year, an average of around 2.5 million per month.
I think you have to pay 300 pesos to if every day you go dive and dive in the sanctuary. And we just talked about that. It was fun. It was a great way because it doesn't mean so much to us, but it's okay that you have to pay to help just a little bit.
All the collection will be deposited to the central government. It will be the DBM, the Department of Budget and Management, will release the fund. 75% goes back to the community, to the protected area. The disadvantage is it takes time, sometimes 10 months, to get your share back to you.
You cannot use the funds anytime you wish because all those remitted to the national government will be taken back only if you can present a project proposal, implementation plan.
To change that system now is you need to amend the law which was passed by the Protected Area Management Board. That's why very important for the protected area is the majority of the decision there will be from the community.
So they have signed a petition. Almost all people of Alahid have signed a petition to reverse it back, the management to the local government unit, so that 100% of the control and income will be collected and implemented for Apo Island's development.
In Apo Island, our focus now at the moment is not only the marine sanctuary. We would like also to protect the whole island. The people here understand very much that we have to take care of our reef, the marine resources, because they understand already that the out of protecting the marine resources, it improved their fish catch. Tourism is only sideline. It's only sideline for some people here in the community.
Paminsan-minsan, kasi yung aming mga fishermen, talaga livelihood nila fishing, mayroong bamboo trap. Tapos sinisira yan sa mga divers. Kasi yung ibang mga divers, makita nila yung isda sa loob ng bamboo trap. ano yun nila, sirain yung bamboo trap, tapos para makalabas yung isda.
Kawawa naman. Mahal naman paggawa yan. Tag-2,000. Sirain lang.
2004, started May, nag-training kami ng mga fisherman na marunong sila magda-dive. Tapos tinatawag namin sila na mga dive ranger.
Kapag mayroong diving, puntahan namin yan. May service kami na speedboat, puntahan namin doon. Tapos sinusulat, may slip kami, sinusulat namin kung anong ginawa nila sa ilalim.
Ang sabi ko sa kapitan, Kap, mabuti pa. Kap, control mo na ating diving sa sanctuary. Oo, nabulabog ang isda. Kahit gabi, may flashlight, mag-shooting. Pero hindi na nakatulong ang isda.
Kung pwede lang, limited ang divers. So kung may pira na ang apo, hindi na kailangan ng mga divers na income ng 200 per head, 300 per head. So kahit 10 lang na divers o 20 every day, so malaki na ang income, di ba? Mayroon ding mga divers na bad, na makasira talaga sa sa corals. Pero yung mga divers, hindi yung taga-apo. How about the fishermen here? Mga uncle ko yan, mga cousins. Kasi relatives ko lahat yun dito. Anong mangyayari kung masira yung corals dito? Sila ang kawawa.
Ako, napasalamat ako na gawa ko ng dive ranger kasi gusto ko maprotektahan talaga yung karagatan natin dito. Dahil kami, dyan na buhay kami.
Kaya sa amin yun, huwag mong sirain yun, corals. Yung paglaki ang corals, maraming isa dito. Kayo naman ang kuwana. Oh, sa inyo naman yan. Okay, tinuruan kayo para sa inyo. Kinabukasan ninyo.
I was walking in the beach and I saw there's two boats with three baskets full of starfish. I said, do not get starfish here because he's not allowed. So I report there to the army and they let them put the starfish back. So they put it back and they went back here. And the barangay said, do not do that again.
It's really nice that it's kept the little island touch that I think it has. It's not the, it doesn't feel like it's full of tourists.
Very clean coastal area, no obstructions, and fishes are jumping out of the, even just in shallow area. Then all people living in the shoreline are now giving the 100% concern on managing the area. Then the local government unit, whoever the leaders are, they to adhere to what the community sa practice and get involved.
I would say the best dives I've had has been on the Philippines.